Students, how are you all? Hope you all are fine and relaxed after vacations. Now we will continue our chapter 2nd of history on the trail of earliest people. What we are going to study in this chapter? We are going to study about the earliest people. Why were they on the move? Making stone tools. A changing environment. We will study about agricultural revolution, division of human historical time. Here we have divided human historical time into three phases. First, Paleolithic, then Mesolithic, and then Neolithic. Then we will bind the chapter with the rock paintings of France. Before starting this chapter, there are few questions comes to our mind. Do the children during that period used to go to school as children go today? Do the children play with Legos? Do they had transport like trains and buses in the ancient age? There are some questions that quickly comes to our mind. So let's see how the things were in the earliest time. Now we will be talking about Paleolithic age. So Paleolithic age, Paleolithic word itself drive. Paleo means old and lithic means stone. So we will be talking about oldest part of the stone age. Now these earliest people were predominantly what? Hunters. And when we say hunters, the animals are that kind who were very robust, alert, quick, and have a presence of mind to catch the animals. So as a hunter, they were doing good job. But some of them were gatherer. So they used to collect plants or parts of plants. Again, they had pretty good knowledge because they were able to understand that this part of a plant is ripe and this is the only part that could be eaten by us. Now, so there was a kind of a knowledge that existed, considering the fact based on the activity they were doing. Now, despite all this thing, they used to move from place to another. Why did it happen? Why they start moving from one place to another? The basic idea was, if they were hunting constantly at one place and gathering food constantly at one place, all the resources would be exhausted, because at that point of time they were unaware how to grow crops. So growing of the crops, domestication of animals were not a part and parcel of their earliest people. So what for that would be exhausted of resources. So therefore they used to move from one place to another. Again, the people who were hunting had to move with animals. Why they used to move with animals? Because what happened? Animals move from place to place. So with the animals, they have to move. So to hunt the animals, they would be obviously moving from one place to another. Those who were growing crops, growing plants, had to vary things according to the seasons. In some seasons, some plant could grow, and in other season, other plant could grow. So based on the region they are staying, and they would have to have plant sources, they would have to consume. For growing, they need water, and for water again, they used to live close to the water sources or the sources of the stone. Those were the two predominant idea where they used to live, either the water source or the stone source. Now why? Because water source was required for the survival. We also need water, and stone source was the source where they could make the equipments to hunt or gather the food, to cut the trees, to get the food from the trees and so. Now, when we say water source, if water is perennial, perennial, beta, you know what is the meaning of perennial? Perennial means perennial source of water are the those river and lakes in which water is available throughout the year. Ganga river, Yamuna river, these all rivers are perennial rivers. If it is perennial, though, then it is fine. But if it is not perennial, then not perennial means non-perennial source. Then what will happen? And what is non-perennial? Non-perennial source of water are those rivers and lakes in which water is not available throughout the year. Water in them get dried up in summer season, like Mahanadi and Krishna. So if they are not perennial, again they have to move from place to one place to another in search of water. And finally, the idea of socialization comes to our mind. Beta, thank you for this session, and I will continue my chapter with a new topic. Until, thank you. Have a nice day.